Hi, before we actually get started with the learning exercises, I want to go ahead and talk a little bit about this window. And I actually go ahead and talk about this in some of the other videos, but some people have made comments that it would be really helpful at the very start if I just go over how to arrange and work with the different panels that are in this window. So let's go ahead and look at that. There's really three distinct areas in this window right now. There's your main area right here, there are your panels over here, and there's your properties window down here at the bottom. Now, starting off really quickly, our panels window right over here. I can expand and collapse this area by clicking the double arrow right here. You'll see how that opens it up and collapses it. Now, you're going to notice that when it's collapsed, I've got three tabs here, and then a divider and two tabs here. And those correspond to the two areas that I have open in my panels right now. You can see I've got CSS Styles, AP Element, and Tag Inspector right here. And I've got Files and Assets down here. And I collapse that, you'll see how those correspond there. So you can expand and collapse that however you prefer to work. Since the size of the video is kind of limited, I'm going to usually leave these collapsed. But again, you can expand them and collapse them at will. And also remember that there are different tabs up here that show you different things. For instance, here I've got Files, here I've got Assets. So there are always tabs here. Now, you also have the Properties panel right down here at the bottom. And it doesn't expand and collapse the way this panel window over here does. But what you can do with it is you can double click on the title. And when you double click on the word properties right here, you're going to see how that drops down to the very bottom. So you can now have more room in your work area. And again, a lot of people prefer to work like this because it gives you the maximum available space to actually work on the web page that you're working on. And again, to bring this back up, you just simply double click on it or click the double arrow to drop that out. Now, you can also turn these areas off and on by going up here to the window menu. For example, if I come down here, I can see, whoops, I see this is the properties panel. But if I go to window, I can come up in here and turn these off. There's properties. If I click it, it collapses. I come up here again and click, it reappears. And the same thing is true over here for our panels. If I come here to the window option and I come over here and click on files, you're going to see that jumps out. If I was to come to window and select CSS styles, that panel is going to jump out for me. And that works a little bit differently depending on whether this is expanded or collapsed. When it's collapsed and you click the button, that area just sort of flies out there for you. And actually, a lot of people, even if they're not limited on space, prefer it to actually jump out, because you can see here the amount of space I have for the files panel when it's open. But if I collapse it, you can see I have more space. Now, when these windows jump out, you can also adjust the amount of space that's given to them. If I point here in the lower left hand corner of this window, you can see I can expand and collapse that so that I can see more or less depending on what exactly it is I'm doing. And the same thing will work here for CSS styles. You can expand that and make it as big or as small as you want. So none of these particular views have an advantage over the other. It's whatever you're most comfortable with in working with in these areas. Now, there are more panels than just the five that appear right here. And a lot of times things will appear down here in properties as well. For example, if you did the find and the search, those results will appear down here. Or if you go to the window menu and let's say I select database here, you can see that grouping opens up over here. So you can open and close different areas on here by using the window menu as well. So that's just a really brief introduction to organizing your workspace inside of Dreamweaver. And again, one doesn't have an advantage over the other. It's just however you prefer to work.